Hi there, I am back. Sorry it has been a while, but here I am making another video. And today's video is about a volunteer trip I had back in January. You might heard of YMCA before. During every winter and summer break, they host international volunteer programs for students to participate in. And last year I had the opportunity to volunteer in Nepal. It was an absolutely wonderful experience. We taught in an elementary school in a small village, and we had a lot of fun with the kids, and we also went to places like Buddhist temple, nature attractions, etc. And I was very touched by the warmth of people and the beautiful culture there. It has been a very unbelievably inspiring experience. But there's one pity. Although it seems like a very great photographic opportunity, I wasn't really into photography at that time, so very few photos were taken during that trip, except some stupid selfies. But this year, however, things are a little different. I signed up for the volunteering again because my friend invited me to. One big difference is that due to the pandemic, we aren't able to go abroad, so all the volunteer programs had all become domestic. Doesn't seem as exciting, huh? But I still think it's a very meaningful thing to do. And another big difference is that I have a camera with me now, and I do photography now. And I was pretty sure that there would be many interesting things to document. And it also seemed like a pretty great way to start my film photography experience. Ah, yes, I haven't talked about it before. Hold up. I started shooting film recently, and this camera was given to me by a friend of my parents. Do you want to see it up close? Never mind, it's too dark. So where was I? Oh yeah, this camera was given to me by a friend of my parents because he knew that I have always wanted to try shooting film. So thank you. I have a lot of fun with this camera, and I'm going to make another video talking about my experience shooting film. But today's video, I guess it's going to be focused on the trip and the photos I took on that trip. So yeah, let's go. Where we were going was a place called Lugu. It's a little township located in Nantou, the center of Taiwan. We stayed there for 8 days and spent most of our time in an elementary school teaching kids. It's like a winter camp to them, pretty similar to what we did in Nepal.
打扰了。不好意思打扰。
So about our plan, the first day was for preparation. We slept in the school classrooms for 7 days, so we spent time cleaning up the place. Also, we needed to get our teaching materials and stuff ready by this day. The winter camp started next day from Monday to Friday, and I was looking forward to capture some joyful photographs of the unreserved emotions of the kids. And we visited some tourist spots on Saturday. It was one of the very few opportunities that we got to leave the school and explore the town. I was actually expecting more days like this, but we only got one instead, so I've really got a sight of this one. I hope to get some nice landscape or street photos on that day. The first and second day was so exhausting. A lot of kids weren't under control. I mean, it's fun though. Most of the kids seemed to have a good time. It didn't take long to break the ice with them. And in fact, they really liked me because I was always being tolerant and very nice. But maybe too nice. So some of them think I'm a pushover and I often got bullied by the kids. I found out I had so much to learn. To me, it's easy to get along with children, but very hard to set the boundary. I was pretty much drained every day. We did have group meetings every night discussing the problems we faced during the day. And I had learned some tips on taking care of children, so it was getting a little better. And the lessons we prepared for them also did pretty well. When seeing these kids having fun, I saw the same kind of smiles I've seen in Nepal. They are so easy to feel satisfied. Very little things can make them so delighted. And it got me thinking about what happiness is. Most of our lives are overwhelmed with information and material things, causing us to have more desire. But these things might not be proportional to our sense of happiness. Because happiness isn't always about how much do you have, but about how much you appreciate what you have. So spending time with these kids reminded me about the feeling of being a kid. Things can be so simple yet so pleasant. After those 5 tiring but fun days, we had to say goodbye. And it got pretty emotional somehow. A lot of kids were crying and stuff. Some of us are in tears too, but I guess it's a good thing because it shows how much we had fun and how much we care about each other.
来，第一站，消防局到了，请右转。
After the reluctant goodbye, we finally can get some rest. We usually had dinner in the school, but this time we were able to eat at a local night market. So, it means finally some decent street photography opportunity.The night market was small but crowded. I like the mood of it. It's such a simple and lively place.
哎呀，哎呀，你过去了，就回向呢。待在这里哦，待在这里哦，不要动。
Lugu is known for its nature scenery and tea. First, we went to a tea house and watched the process of tea making, from roasting to refining and stuff. I'm not that much of a tea person, but it was fun to see the whole process, and it smelled pretty good.
二梯的车外面，
拿走，
不要，
心灵守卫人负义，阿门。
我也不太懂怎么去讲。那，好，你们要找寻到自己两个人相处最舒服的一个方式。就算有时候有些人为什么远距离他们可以不分开是那么的好，你们都没有了。为什么？因为他从来都没有真正的去上线过、了解过，或者他只是为了他自己。
好，来，谢谢标本老师拍手。Yeah.
对。
Spring is the season for cherry blossoms, and here in Lugu there's a park full of sakura trees. They were planted in the 2000s, so the trees are still pretty small, but they did leave some space for them to grow, so I guess the park will be even more beautiful when the cherry trees got taller over time.There are many great scenes on the way, and I had got some decent shots. I have really enjoyed the place. Being in that different environment had been very refreshing. Our last destination was a bamboo forest, and it was chill and a bit mysterious.Feel like a scene of a martial arts film or something. I love the atmosphere. We later went back to the school to have dinner and stuff and get prepared to leave on the next day. And that's pretty much it. That was my volunteer trip in Lugu. In conclusion, it was interesting. Although it probably wasn't as inspiring or as interesting as the trip I had back in Nepal. And taking care of children was certainly way harder than I thought. But the joyful smiles of the kids had, I guess, made everything worth it. To me or to us, those 5 days might have been pretty exhausting, but to the kids, it could have been a very great memory, and I feel very satisfied thinking about that. And I guess I am very glad to help making their winter break more fun. And also, it was very great to hang out with those volunteer friends. I'm not a very outgoing person. In fact, maybe back in 1 or 2 years ago, I was usually pretty nervous about socializing. But recently, I've grown a lot mentally, and I'm more comfortable with people now. I often found myself enjoying being with friends, and this time in Lugu, I guess I have noticed my growth even more. So I'm very thankful to meet those cool people and do such meaningful things together. And yeah, that's it. If you have any suggestions on my video or on my photography, please feel free to let me know, because since I'm still learning, your opinions might help me a lot. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your time. And I'll see you next time. Bye bye.
Yay!
你要讲几秒啊？哦。